Hello.
Hi.
Hey, Katie. Hi, how are you?
These doctor's appointments are a part of Katie Beaver's routine.
So the electrical wires, everything is connected good.
Her neurologist, Dr. David Vossler, is adjusting the settings on a new device Katie has. It's to help her epilepsy.
My first seizure was actually happened in my kitchen.
Katie was 10, and for the past two decades, the seizures never stopped.
I've actually tried every single medication that there is to try for people like me. Lately, within the past few years, I ended up having, you know, several a day to, you know, but it would be very sporadic. It'd be anywhere from 10, maybe 5 or 2, or it'd be 30 even.
It's unpredictable and dangerous. She's burned herself from hot water while cooking, cut her head, and
I've actually fallen into toilets and broken them. I did that in my last apartment, and that was awful.
Hi!
How's it going?
So after speaking with her doctors, she agreed to try something new.
He's an incredible doctor. He actually said if I was to have my daughter have this surgery, I would want Dr. Ko, the surgeon that I had, to do it.
Dr. Andrew Ko implanted a new kind of device to deliver deep brain stimulation. DBS sends electrical pulses to certain parts of the brain to control abnormal activity.
The reason that people came up with this device is to kind of reduce the burden on the patient and the doctor in terms of trying to remember, you know, what times of day are good or bad for you, because the device itself can take snapshots of the brain activity at certain points in time.
These markers are important.
Potentially seeing what the brain is doing could give you a signal that, okay, if we see this happen, odds are they will have fewer seizures. That could be an important thing to look for when trying to use these types of devices.
She's had the implant now for about a month.
It's actually cut down how many times I have seizures a day. So there's been days where I don't have any at all, which is astronomical, awesome. I'm more confident in walking just by myself to the bathroom, to the kitchen, to get some water and not worrying about spilling it or anything like that.
While she still isn't sure what the future holds,
you know, I just take things slowly, day by day.
She dreams of a day when not having seizures will be her norm.
I hope for it. I definitely hope for it.
From the UW Medicine Newsroom in Seattle, I'm Katie Chen.